Good morning. Banking Committee will now come into order. This is the last meeting of this session, unless something happens, of the Banking Committee. I am really glad to have had the pleasure of working with you. I will notice that we have Senators Thomas, Savino, May, and Bridgeport here. Senator Borello, is there any last word, since you're the ranker, is there any last word that you would like to make on this committee?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just want to say that I believe this is an important committee that impacts a lot of organizations across the state, and certainly a lot of people, the people of New York State. And it's my honor to be the ranking member of this committee, and thank you very much.
You're more than welcome. Since this is the last meeting, is there anything that any committee member wants to say before we begin? We shall begin. Laura is going to, from my staff, is going to help us on this process. Laura, would you be kind enough to read the bills?
Okay, the first bill on the agenda is S-239. The sponsor is Senator Thomas. The title is An Act to Amend the Financial Services Law in relation to the jurisdiction of the Department of Financial Services over the financing of motor vehicles, and to amend the vehicle and traffic law in relation to the licensing of motor vehicle dealer finance mergers.
Senator Thomas, is there anything that you'd like to say?
This is a long time coming. We need to give DFS proper oversight over the auto lending industry. Right now, DFS has oversight over mortgages and student loans, but auto loans were not part of that. So we're giving them the authority to oversee it, given the countless complaints in the state over the auto lending industry, and we just need to have more oversight on this. So thank you for supporting this bill.
Thank you, sir. Senator Borello, even before you speak, if you could identify the Republicans that have just joined us.
Sure. Thank you very much. In addition to me, I have Senator Dan Steck and Senator Jim Todisco joining us. Thank you. So first of all, I want to say, Senator Thomas, I understand that there are bad actors out there, and I appreciate the spirit of this. But as we often do, we tend to overcompensate, and I think that's exactly what this is. If we're going to address the bad actors, we have legal recourse to do that now. Our district attorney, our AG's office. But what this will do is, you mentioned that mortgages. Well, what we have with mortgages is it takes, in New York State, sometimes months to get a mortgage because of all the regulations. And not that we shouldn't be looking for fraud or people being abused by bad actors, but I'm just very concerned, particularly where I live, because if you drive around my district, you'll see that many of the license plate covers on cars come from dealerships in Pennsylvania, because you can literally stand with one foot in my district and the other foot in the state of Pennsylvania for about 100 miles straight. And we already lose a lot of business to out-of-state auto dealers where I live. And that's, certainly an issue from a jobs standpoint, economic activity standpoint. So, but also this bill really gives a tremendous amount of regulatory authority to DFS when it comes to this. And I'm just, I have a lot of concerns on this impacting the industry, and also, giving New York State just one more, stranglehold on economic engines like car dealers, which are a big economic engine. They are the number one supplier of sales tax revenue in New York State, outside of New York City. Number two, I might add, is restaurants. But this is just not something that I think is necessary. We should be focused on the bad actors. So thank you.
If I may respond, Chair.
I'll let you respond, and then Diane. Sir.
So common abuses of these auto lenders are expensive add-ons, markups, and even the FTC did an investigation over one such dealership that showed a continued pricing disparity and discrimination against people of color. So, we need to have oversight. All right. To leave it the way it is not going to solve the problem, because the district attorneys and other regulatory agencies have their plates full. And DFS has been doing a really good job on cracking down on such abuses and setting forth regs. And I think this is just common sense to add auto lending under their purview as well.
Thank you. I yield to the ranker.
I just out of respect for time and for Senator Thomas, we'll save the rest of the debate for the floor. So thank you.
Was that a promise?
I'll take it. I'll take it.
To both Senator Thomas and Senator Borrello, I agree with both of you and both in different aspects. This bill is not a new bill to this committee. In fact, if you look at the history of the bill, it goes back to 2015, and it was a result of an extensive report and a study that was done by myself and other former members of the Senate when we did an intensive look at what was called subprime lending in the auto industry. Shortly after, the state took on the issue of subprime lending in the home buying industry, and we came up with a set of regulations that changed the way people were able to secure mortgages and be protected from the subprime lending industry. We found that a lot of the bad actors in the subprime lending industry just shifted to the auto industry, particularly in the secondary market. And we set forward a whole host of attempted changes to the auto industry and the purchasing of cars. Some of those bills did not make it through. This was one of them, but this is a comprehensive approach at trying to bring more transparency to the purchase of vehicles, especially in the secondary market. Senator Thomas talked about some of the things like add-ons and unnecessary aftermarket purchases. It is very difficult for the average consumer to know what they should and shouldn't buy in when you are being pressured to purchase something at an auto dealer. In addition, there's also, we found that there was one of the issues was that auto in the contract, they're not required to give you a copy of the contract, which didn't seem to make any sense to us at the time. So there was a bunch of things that came out of that report, and some of them were implemented, some of them weren't. This was one that did not finally get implemented, so it's long overdue. But at the same time, Senator Borrello, you're right. Auto dealers are highly regulated in this state. They are required to exist under very specific rules and regulations. They are only allowed to operate within a certain number of miles away from each other. They are sole proprietors. They pay taxes. They are integral parts of our community. It's one of the many reasons why I have been working for the past several years on regulating auto brokers, most of whom are outlaws in this state. And I know Senator Thomas is helping me work on that through his Consumer Affairs Committee. So I'm going to vote for this bill because it is long overdue. It will actually help the auto buying industry in New York State because it'll bring more transparency so customers will feel more secure about what they're purchasing and what they're getting. And in the end, it'll be better for the consumer. So I hope that that brought some clarity to it. And if any of you would like to read that long ago issued report, I still have a copy of it, Subprime Lending in the Auto Industry. I have a whole bunch of reports if any of you would like them. And they were pretty thorough and examined this industry inside and out.
I'll take them all.
I encourage everyone to get that report. I remember when it came out, it was one of the better reports that was that was done. Is there any other question, comment, or statement on this issue before we call a question? All right, I will accept the motion.
Move the bill.
Motion by Senator Bridgeport, second by Senator May. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay. I trust you're recording this, Laura.
Yes, I am.
All without rec? All right, this motion is passed and it's referred to finance, Laura, would you be kind enough to take us? I think I know the author of the next three. He really does a good work on making sure that it's well thought of. So Laura, would you take us through these things?
Okay, the next bill is S-670. Sponsor is Senator Sanders.
The title is An Act to Amend the General Municipal Law and the Banking Law in Relation to Allowing Credit Unions, Savings Banks, Savings and Loan Associations, and Federal Savings Associations to Accept and Secure Deposits from Municipal Corporations, to Direct the Department of Financial Services to conduct a study and issue a report concerning the impacts of allowing certain financial institutions to accept local government public deposits, and providing for the repeal of certain provisions upon the expiration thereof.
Among the beneficiaries, I see a slew of hands. I will hold my point and let's see the ranker first, and then Senator Savino.
Yes. Yes, certainly you should get the last word, Mr. Chairman, on this one. So, we've seen this bill before, and I've made my comments, but I want to start off by saying one thing. I've been in business a long time, and I've written and participated in a lot of mission statements. And, you know, I think credit unions are fantastic organizations. I think that they serve a lot of people, but the mission statement, they've gone well beyond their mission, quite frankly, in my opinion. You know, when I was a young person, my first car loan, when I was still in college, came from a credit union. It was a credit union that served the employees of a certain group of people. And that's what credit unions are supposed to be doing. They're supposed to serve certain specific communities, employees of a certain company, if you're a certain occupation or trade. Now they've become large international financial institutions. And the key point is they do not pay a dime in taxes. And the concept of them taking municipal deposits, taking taxpayer money, and then potentially even investing that money in places, that are outside of New York State. And ultimately that having the problem that they're taking taxpayer dollars, but they actually aren't paying taxes. That is my fundamental problem with this. And I have some questions if you want to go through them, but I'd let Senator Savino talk first, if that's okay.
Thank you, Senator Borrello. So I don't really have a lot to add to yours. So as you know, Senator Sanders, in the past, when I chaired the banking committee, this is an issue that's come up over and over. The credit unions have attempted to expand their business model beyond what it was originally intended to do. They are membership-driven organizations. I myself have been, in the past, a member of the Municipal Credit Union as a former city employee. We have CEFQ is here on the concourse. But credit unions are not banks. If they want to be banks, we can make them banks. We can introduce legislation to change their nonprofit status and allow them to act like a bank fully in all manner, including paying taxes. Remember, credit unions do not have to service people that are not their members. They don't lend to people that are not their members. So for us to allow them to have access to municipal deposits, I think is a mistake. So I'm going to continue to be a negative on this bill. And so if credit unions, again, if they want to be banks and get all the full benefits of being a bank, including municipal deposits, let's change their charter, allow them to be banks, allow them to pay taxes, open up their doors to everyone, not just members who fit whatever their original charter was. And then we can be in full support of that. And so I will continue to be a no on that. And I thank you for your efforts, though, but you haven't convinced me yet.
Well, stick around, Diane, stick around. I suspect that won't happen. Senator May.
Yeah, thank you. I'm gonna weigh in on the other side. I am strongly in support of this bill. I joined the Syracuse Cooperative Federal Credit Union as soon as I moved to Syracuse. And it is an institution that serves, it has some of the only Spanish speaking tellers. It serves communities that have been underbanked forever and really takes its mission seriously to serve anybody who is who has difficulty getting access to banking services. So I definitely think that it makes sense to offer them this opportunity as well, and that they will invest the money, they put whatever profits they make back into the community in absolutely important and critical ways. And so I am very supportive of this, and thank you for this bill.
I'll speak last. I will yield to Senator Bridgeport, of course, and anyone else who wants to speak. Sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'm you know, going to be without rec on this one. I think I was last year too. I have a slightly different critique than my colleagues. I do have tons of love for credit unions and also expanding the number of ways that, you know, our working class constituents can, you know, have their deposits done. But my biggest support is for your other bill, which is for a public bank in the state of New York. And I am eagerly awaiting the day which I can vote yes on that in this committee. And I do have concerns that taking steps like this bill takes undermines our ability to get to, you know, what we need for a fully public bank. So I just want to say that, and you know, thank you for your continued leadership on this committee.
Thank you, sir. Is there anyone else before I speak, before I weigh in? Senator Borrello.
If I could just ask one or two questions here. And
absolutely, sir.
I appreciate it. So obviously, if this were to go through, this could potentially cost the state some tax dollars. Do you have any idea? We have any kind of estimate on how much lost tax revenue we might see should this go through?
No, but I'm sure that the finance and others will come up with an estimate, sir.
Okay, it'd be good to see that. That would be great. Just because, you know, obviously that's we're always talking about revenue, and this would be certainly a hit to our revenue there. I made mention in my opening statement about the potential of essentially New York State and municipal tax dollars being deposited into credit unions and other places. Would they then be able to turn around and invest that money? Because keep in mind, if you're talking about let's say you're a small credit union in an area with a municipality, this could end up being the vast majority of their depository. In fact, I would imagine it would be. In some small credit unions, and particularly in rural upstate New York. So now you're talking about the majority of their deposits being from taxpayers and taxpayer dollars. Would they then turn around and invest that money potentially out of state?
It is conceivable, sir, but I don't know of any credit union that invests out of state, sir.
Okay. Well, again, I think that's a question we'd want to have answered. And if there's no guardrails for that, then it wouldn't stop that, especially if you're talking about a large influx of new capital for them that they're going to need to manage somehow. The last one is, you know, banks right now, they buy, you know, tax-free municipal bonds. And as a former county executive, I know how important that is to collateralize those municipal deposits. Will the credit unions be required to do that?
I believe so, sir. I believe that they will have to meet the same regulations if you're talking about this money. And in fact, since that was your last point, let me give two points that I'm hoping may sway people on this. Upstate New York, especially, we're seeing a trend where whole communities do not have banks. Whole communities are taking all of their resources and taking them to other communities. This may give an opportunity for a community to keep its money in its own community instead of, giving it to Utica or Syracuse or wherever you are. You may have the ability to deposit locally as a community. Another point that I'm going to, and it wasn't really addressed here, I am working and fighting on a CRA for credit unions. Anyone, and I agree with the basic argument that many people have put up, that anyone who takes public money should have an obligation to the public, if you wish. And I too am concerned that a credit union is looking at its members, but I believe that with a CRA, they will have to give back to the community as a whole. So I believe that I'm trying to address part of the concern that I share with several members up here. That bill is forthcoming. It has to be very properly done. So we're taking our time with that one, but you will see that. Senator Borrello.
Just quickly, just to clarify that last point you make, because I think it's an important one. So you want to revamp the laws so that these institutions will have to follow the Community Reinvestment Act?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right.
So we have to write that carefully, as you can imagine. But if they're taking the public funds, then they have an obligation to the public. while their members are worthy, and thank God for them, we also have an obligation to the public since this is public funds. So I'm working on those areas that, some of those areas of your concern, sir.
All right, well, thank you. Again, we'll if there's more engagement needed, we'll save it for the next step, but thank you.
Yes, let's stay on this one. This is not, I mean, this is not finished. Even if we do this, I laws are never done, if you wish. There's always better ways of doing it, and we should always look for those ways. We should not be stuck and just say, okay, this is it, and that's all there is. Laws, like humans, are works in progress. At least I am. Is there any further question, comment, or statement on this issue? I will accept the motion. It has been motioned by Senator Thomas, second by Senator May. All in favor say aye. I will take that to, I have the papers, so I know the ayes. All opposed say nay. You ever notice that noes will speak, but ayes won't? It's amazing. all without rec, please make your-
Without rec.
Yes. This motion passes. Thank you. It's reported out of the committee. Thank you very much. But I really appreciate the spirited debate on this. It makes it better, my friends. It doesn't make it worse. It makes it better. And we should sharpen ourselves. Laura, will you take us to the next one?
Okay. This bill is S-1061-B. And this is Senator Sanders as a sponsor. The title is An Act to Amend the Banking Law and the Administrative Code of the City of New York in relation to regulating commercial finance licensing, establishing minority and women-owned business protection program.
All right. Are there any questions, comments, or statements on this? Sir, Senator Borrello.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. You know, this is, sometimes we talk about getting down in the weeds on something, and that's where I'm having some issues. I think it's a laudable effort, what you're trying to do with this bill. My concern is, as I mentioned before, we are giving an extraordinary amount of power to the Department of Financial Services and more increases in regulations and so forth that to me are the ultimate reasons why I'm opposed to this bill. And I really just think that, you know, again, as a business owner in New York State, you know, the state has its hands in every part of our business. I mean, if I could give you a laundry list of agencies that I have to, you know, deal with, report to, account to, and I own a restaurant. It's not like I'm, you know, we're on a nuclear power plant. I own a restaurant. I've got DEC, Department of Labor, sales tax, Department of Health. So this is just one more situation where I just don't think we need to have DFS have oversight. So that's my statement. But I, again, appreciate the intent.
Very worthy point, sir. My libertarian impulses really are with you on this one, in the sense of I wish that these laws were not necessary. I sometimes wonder why the financial industry is not just following what some say are the rules of capitalism. Why aren't we just doing smart things with money? Unfortunately, we're not seeing that, and therefore a role for government is not only sought, but required, that you have to make sure that the playing field is an even one. And under those conditions, this is why this bill is sought, sir. If there are any other questions, comments, or statements on this one. If not, I will accept a motion. A motion by Senator May, second by Senator Bridgeport. All in favor say aye. Maybe raise your hands. Okay, I'll do, yes, that makes more sense. I trust you got that, Laura. All opposed say, raise your hand.
Hey, oh, sorry.
You'll do both. Why not? All without rec. Please raise your hand. All right, this motion passes, and it is referred to finance. last but never least. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. Oh, you make sure he's a deputy.
I wanted to make sure you had me in the negative on the last one.
Oh, what a shame. We were going to put you in the positive, sir.
I'm just making sure.
Still have time. I'll change that. All right. Counter to the negative. Last bill, Laura.
Okay. This bill is S5201. The sponsor is Sanders. The title is An Act to Amend the Banking Law in Relation to Establishing the New York State Money Transmission Disclosure Act.
Questions, comments, or statements on this one? Now, this one seems easy. I like easy. You sure, Senator Borrello? Surely there's something.
I'm going to vote no, but I will refrain.
Okay.
In the interest of time.
Well, consistency is always a good thing, I believe. All in favor, please raise your hand. All opposed, raise your hand. All without rec, please raise your hand. This motion passes and is referred out of committee. My friends, I really have enjoyed the committee. We have to, in the days to come, let us work more. I don't know. I went up to Watertown some time ago and I saw a great need to do some work in the northern part of our great state of New York. These whole communities that don't have banks, et cetera. We have to figure this thing out, my friends. We've got to do something. There's one New York, and under those conditions, we shall not let our northern neighbors go down the drain. So if we could just figure some things that will help the North, even as we work on the rest of the state, I would appreciate it. And I urge my colleagues from the North to be bold and to come to this committee and let's not get caught up with partisanship. Let's try to figure out what is good for the people up there and how do we just make it get through this committee, knowing that we live in a real world and it's we're the whole world is not of the same mind of this committee. So having said that, and yes, Senator Bridgeport, the public banks is so overdue. In fact, we will be at a demonstration on the $1 million steps today. I know I will, in support of public banks. And Senator Steck, we will leave room for you and Senator Bridgeport. I'm sorry, Senator Borrello, to join us on this for public banks.
Sadly, I have a conflict, Mr. Chairman.
I am without words and without record that last statement.
But I appreciate your sentiments about upstate, by the way. Thank you.
Yes. It's separate issues, my friend. Let's separate that and let's do something about those. Is there anybody who wants to make a last statement before we close this one? Having said that, I will take a motion to adjourn. A motion to adjourn by Senator May, second by Senator Borrello. All in favor, say aye.
Raise your aye. Hand.
All opposed, say nay, without rec. Standing without rec. This committee is now adjourned.